y'all, this is Tyler and Maddie and Riley down there from O.T.R. Outdoors. I started on Bushcraft USA about a month ago now. I started a fitness and skills thread. So today we're going to do one of those workouts. Actually, we're going to combine two of the workouts. The way it works is you post a workout, and whoever completes the workout first, not counting the person who posted it, gets to create the new workout. So I posted the first workout. One of the guys completed it, and he posted a workout. The workout he posted, we had to postpone because it required snow and ice. And most of us thawed out by the time that workout got posted. So I got to get this workout done today because the snow is supposed to start melting today. And then I posted a workout. Basically, we delayed that workout that required the snow and ice. So I posted another workout that was a boil water. Start a fire in boil water after a run or jog. His workout was to shovel off your driveway of snow, basically something to get the heart rate up. I'm not going to shovel my driveway because our driveway is gravel. What I'm going to do is combine the two workouts together because his was shovel the driveway, get the heart rate up, and build a split wood fire out of a piece of wood that was frozen and covered in snow. So what we're going to do is I'm going to shovel off the two porches on our house, the two back porches that are covered in snow, and then we're going to go do a short ruck, probably a half mile ruck, and then we're going to build the fire, a split wood fire, char some material. That was the other part of his challenge. And then, what are you doing? Don't throw that on me, please. And then full water and start the fire. So we're going to shovel off everything, go for a quick ruck through the woods, and then while we're out there, we're going to build our fire and char some material and boil water. So that's the challenge for today, the workout challenge. So we're gonna get started. So that's as good as it's going to get for the shovel I've got. Got both of the porches done. I may break the broom out and sweep some of this off later, but not right now. We're going to finish up this first. So that's all good. So now we're going to go do at least a half mile with her on my back, and then we'll get our fire started from there.
0.5 miles. I'm not gonna stop because I gotta put my glove back on here when I start this. Here, we'll do this. We'll go ahead and start it and it'll have a little extra time because I gotta get everything, gloves and everything back on. You say hi, Maddie? All right, so we just finished. We're gonna go.
So here's our piece of wood here. All covered in snow. the girls ended up getting a little too cool before we could get everything finished. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get everything a little bit closer to the house. We're not far from the house where we were at earlier. I'm gonna slide everything a little bit closer to the house, and I'm going to jog a half mile so that I'm back at that elevated heart rate, and then take the rest of the log that I was working on, split it down the rest of the way, and then start from there and do everything else the same again. So let me get everything moved over, and then we'll start the run, and we'll go from there. Half mile. Back settings. I'm going to change my countdown. And I'm going to leave it at 9 seconds because I got to put it in my vest. There's that. Yeah. Hit start here. Starting the workout. Let's do a nice half mile jog real quick. And then we'll start over. The half mile. Just pause. There we go. Half mile. This type of camera, I shed a layer. It's starting to get warm now. I don't have many layers on. I knew even earlier when I was working. I didn't have very many layers on. Sorry, I didn't have very many layers on earlier, so I knew I was gonna start sweating pretty quick. So all I have is a thermal base and just a Under Armour shirt on top. So once I start cooling back down, I'll put those back on. Grab my work gloves and my vest here, grab my chest rig, put this back on. I'm gonna put my leather gloves back on. Keep my hands out of the snow, warm up a little bit. Here, a little cold. I should have grabbed my light running gloves, but here, my glasses are fogging up on me though. So, alright. I have all the stuff from earlier, and then I have that same piece we were cutting on, still got snow on it. And it sat out all weekend in the snowstorm. Cook stuff out of the way here. And I left all this stuff out, so that water's gonna be nice and cold now. Speaking of, let's get a sip real quick. Along with the layers, you know you're going to be moving a lot. Start cold, like I was saying, I didn't wear a lot of layers for the run because I know I get warm quick. If you know you're going to be moving, start out a little cool, you'll warm up. Make sure you hydrate, especially in the snow. You don't think you're sweating, you don't think you're working as hard because you don't get as hot. You gotta hydrate. Oh yeah, nice and cold. And be careful not to take big, huge gulps when your water's cold, because they'll start cooling your core temperature down. So little sips often is a really good way to remember it. That's one thing they always said in the military all the time when we were going to be working where it's cold. Little sips often. Or if you can warm it up, then you can gulp it down because it'll help warm you back up. Knock some of the snow off here. I'm going to start on this bigger end because it's got a few less knots in it. Brush all the snow off the back of your boots. And when you go to sit down, you're not sitting in snow and water. Here's the two pieces I just cut. That one's got a pretty nice check in it. So. Split these super far down. I'll do one pretty far, and then the other one I'm gonna leave fairly big to put my base, and then use that other stuff that I split up a while ago after we did the other part, the other workout before the girls got cold. So I'll go ahead and split these down a few more times, and then that big one that I'm using for baton now, I'll split it down just into quarters. Just getting some more of this stuff broke down into the sizes I need, and then get the fire started, char our material, and pull some water. With got somewhat of a log cabin going here, and I'll get it built up once I get start the fire. I got my small, my medium, and my large stuff over here. Same tin as a while ago with the bark in it. And I got my pot, my water over here, and all my shavings. I'm just gonna go ahead and try and light those straight up, the shavings. All right, here and find some of my really small fine shavings here. I did was I took four main pieces here on the bottom that are my bigger pieces, and I took all the bark and placed it the inner bark up just to give me a bit of a platform off it, so I'm still on the snow minus those logs and this. The only reason I really use the bark is to give me a more solid platform as opposed to the gaps with the logs. I'm going to use my multi-tool, the saw blade on it, the back of the saw. So I got something. I'm gonna do teepee style so it has a chance to dry out some. The rest of that gets going good. Keep your gloves on, let them dry out a little bit. There we go. I'd say we're definitely. When it is 12:36, so we'll say 12:35 because it's been on there for about a minute. And all the prep time took maybe, get everything split down, maybe 20 minutes if that. The run took, I'll have to go back and look at it, I'll show you all that here in a minute, how long the run took. Starting to get a little bit of a bowl going, it's not quite a full rolling bowl yet.
Alright, my GoPro's full. It looks like we've reached the boil. There we go. Full boil. Get that off. And it is 12:41. There we go. Now we just gotta wait. Char tin sitting right there. There's our char tin. Let it finish up. It's probably getting close. I don't see smoke coming out of it anymore. Pull this tin out. Let it cool off. No more smoke coming out of it. Put it right there. There's our tin, pulled out, and let it cool off for a minute. There's our fire, what's left of it, now that we've boiled water and made hopefully charred material. It is cool to the touch. I'm gonna get this up in one hand. There we go, we have now made charred material as well. Get you some better light here. So there is our charred material. So we've made charred material with our fire, as well as boiled water. All right, y'all, that's gonna do it for today. Remember, there's always a storm coming. Keep your powder dry, your action knife sharp, and eye on your back trail. We'll see y'all next time.